in doubles with Rulol against him, and he is like really like he wants to find your openings. Mm-hmm. I had to play against him in one-on-one situation. My partner got killed and his partner got killed, and I had to play against him, and he was like, he doesn't approach, he's not aggressive, he just wants to find these openings.
So a bit more on the side of Tails, right. where exactly. he would play into the strength of Cloud, that he would get stronger as long as he loads up his limit.
Yeah,
I mean, Cloud gets no disadvantage from being patient. Rather, exactly. Other characters are very disadvantaged if they let him do that. And Ezreal actually starting with loading his limit, spacing with up airs, and employing the same tactic that we saw from Tails, just going into platform. Dash attack gets punished by a forward smash. Pao being very passive right now, not trying to follow him up.
Yeah, following Cloud is actually risky, especially with a character that... okay, does he waste the limit?
That was very aggressive.
Oh, okay, you can do that.
Jabs through his side B. I never saw that before. But I'm not seeing much of Lucas anyway, so...
So it's even. It's not like dominating for Ezreal.
Right now, Poe really holding his own against one of... Netherlands' best, if not Europe's best. Misses nice. The grab, but doesn't get punished. Runs into the limit blade beam?
Blade beam, yeah. So he's really playing it well, Pao. Better than I expected, actually.
Try to follow his movement with the Zair, doesn't quite get it.
So Ezreal is doing something that I'm really a fan of. If your opponent is always short hopping, his dash attack is gonna catch him. So Poe is short hopping a lot, which is important for
Lucas.
Important for Lucas, and this is what makes it really hard. So Poe really has to be careful.
Yes, they're killed by the up air. We don't turn the city. That's where the ceiling is. Quite near, the blast zone is quite near, so Pao now on a disadvantage, gets caught up by the up air, gets scooped, but doesn't get much damage after it. Again, up air, and now he's above Cloud and he doesn't want to be there.
Nice, okay, he lost stage control, no punish.
Ezreal also very safe movement on his side, using extended dash dances.
Nice. So that was a mistake, yeah.
And just played it very patiently, very disciplined. Didn't give much openings. Tried to evade the Zairs, tried to evade the options that Poe was throwing at him in neutral. Got the limit, and ended up with a cross slash.
So, I don't know if Poe has any secondaries, but this match didn't look too well. First stock, it looked really well. Second stock, it was like really bad for Poe.
Yeah, somehow he completely lost control of the game. I don't know where Ezreal put that switch in.
But so I don't think it was Poe who got worse. I just think it was Ezreal getting better, learning the matchup in the game.
Yes. So, where Poe felt comfortable when he put in his Zairs. And it really, really looked like Ezreal didn't get hit by any Zairs in the second stock. Really a testament of how much he got used to the spacing. Poe finds an opening with Nairs. Wants to connect forward smash, doesn't get it. Gets a nice 30% now.
Oh, nice.
Well, gets spiked. Has to recover with a B, but gets safety back on stage, but still in disadvantage.
So his jab is really good in this matchup, I've noticed. See?
Yes.
Nice catch.
Gets hit by the down air. Now gets juggled by up airs. Gets another nair and goes into the blast zone. And again, Ezreal, very aggressive off stage. What I didn't expect. Even uses his limit to get this... get through this situation where he could spike him. Now using a blade beam, to slow down the match a bit.
Nice combos.
Grab into...
Just get him off stage, yeah.
Grab into, forward air. Again, first stock, quite even. Now, Azrael has limit. Let's see what he does with it. Up until now, he was very efficient with it. Now, missing the...
That was actually clever. That was so good. Okay, he does a nasty trick.
And catches him with the dash attack. Yeah. As you said, too much jumping, and Azrael was ready for it with the dash attack, hitting him into the blast zone. Now pressuring him on the platform. Paul can escape it.
So Paul really needs that Zair into grab. Getting him off stage is now really important. Especially he has limit now. He has to waste his limit.
Gets the grab, as you said. Gets the fair. What he will do? Oh, almost got it.
Lucky
but
oh my god!
He wanted to do my man from TCL dirty. He really wanted to do him dirty. That could have been a beautiful combo.
Yeah. Nice.
It's like scooping him up with the up air. That was beautiful. Oh, nice. And gets the fair.
So I believe in the comeback. I believe.
You believe. I have to be the non-biased, so I don't believe.
I'm not.
Go Azrael.
I don't say that Poe is gonna win. Smash 4 is just like if you have momentum. If you have momentum and you're in a deficit, you're just gonna make the comment.
Everything is possible.
Yeah, comment for this blessing.
Yeah, yeah. Just bless him. Bless my boy. Jazz him out. Azrael doesn't tech. Very quick on his feet, but get jabbed out again. Gets him off stage with the back air.
Okay.
And again, cross slash.
So that's it.
Very effectively played by Azrael. I think he only used one limit and didn't hit Poe, I think. All the other limit attacks he hit. I think he missed one blade beam.
Yeah, he missed that blade beam read into up smash.
Oh yes, and he missed the down B. I don't know what down B is called, unfortunately.
Finishing touch.
Finishing touch. How could I forget?
I forget attack names as well.
Yes. Yeah, but he lost two. But I thought he was very efficient when it came to his limit use. Very fast Cloud also. Great movement.
Yeah, he is not patient. Cloud is a character you don't have to play patient or you don't have to play aggressive. It's just like Fox or Bayonetta. You have different play styles.
Mm.
It's